Hello everyone, welcome to EduTap. Please let me know if you can hear me and we can begin with your session. Please let me know. I hope that you guys can hear me. Good evening. I'll be waiting for you. In today's session, we'll be discussing ARD current affairs. The most requested session today is. Let me see if you guys can hear me. I'll just wait and then we'll begin. So Ronald is here and one more student is here. Very, very less students. Why? Why is it so that I can see only only few students here today? Most of the people are busy in downloading their admit cards, is it? So yes, admit cards have been out. Please go download your admit card and see when which shift is your exam in. So everyone is here. Let's get started. Nikhil says, sure. So today we'll be discussing ARD current affairs from September, October, November as well as December. Fine. More than 100 questions we'll be discussing. And perfectly imperfect. Thank you so much. You are in love with learning. That's a very good thing. And I'm starting with the September current affairs from ARD section. I hope you have downloaded the video. You have downloaded your admit cards. Fine. So here is your question number one. ECRISAT has tied up with which of the following in September 2019 to help 6,000 royats to turn entrepreneurs. So with which of the following ECRISAT has tied up. Let me see if you guys know the answer. One answer is here. Three, farmer producer company, is it? FPO, Bharat is also saying the same. Okay, so the students have come now. That's really nice. Fourth and third option. Even someone is saying 1, 2, 3. So no unanimity here. 1, 2, 3, 4. All options you guys are trying. ECRISAT has tied up with farmer producer company FPO, FPC to help the 6,000 royals to turn entrepreneurs. According to the study published in Nature Climate Change, continued global warming could lower the banana yield, leading to a drop of 0.59 to 0.19 tons per hectare by the year. Which year is it? 2040, 2022, 2020, 2050 or none of the above? Before telling the answer, those students who are new here, I would just tell you that we are taking these sessions every day at 5:30. Today I was late, okay, another session was going on, most of the students were busy there also. So we 5:30 to 6 p.m. we take your session every day and we discuss all the important components which are related to the current affairs beat, GA beat, ARD beat, ESI in the form of MCQs. More than 100 MCQs are discussed in one video. Okay, so every day these sessions are conducted and we are planning to take these sessions till 24th. I'm also planning to launch the schedule. You will shortly get a schedule as to what are we going to cover in the coming videos. 2050 I've got, coming back to the answer. Correct, 2050 is the answer. Onam Samruddhi mobile app was launched in which of the following states? So Onam Samruddhi mobile app has been launched by Kerala. Central government has decided to give special training to workers under MGNREGA, that is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act scheme. All this training will be given at. So special training to workers under this scheme would be given at KVKs, Krishi Vigyan Kendras. Hurry up, quickly answer the questions so that we can save time and we can cover more and more questions in the given time. Okay. So the number of students have increased. That is really good to know because this is one of the most awaited session. Prime Minister Modi launched the National Animal Disease Control Program for eradicating the FMD and brucellosis in the livestock in 2019 at. So this very important thing take away from the question. A National Animal Disease Control Program has been launched by Prime Minister. It has been launched to eradicate the FMDs foot and mouth diseases as well as brucellosis in the livestock. And thirdly, the scheme was launched in the year 2019. Three important things. Fourthly, where has it been launched? So such a kind of question can be asked in phase one. Mathura, that's right. Mathura is the answer. Karthik is saying, I have given NABHA 2019 and I am in evidence that the study material and the questions are very relevant. Thank you so much, Karthik. This is what keeps us motivated, that you students have so much trust on us and we try to go more than your expectations. Okay, we are trying and we are taking these sessions as just a part of it. We try to cover most of the questions here. We try to make more and more relevant questions so that you can hit the exam. National Animal Disease Control Program has an aim of eradicating the FMD and brucellosis by the year. So year, this is again very important. See, this is important, this Animal Disease Control Program. It is very important for rural India, if the NABHA says it has focus on rural India. So the answer here is 2030. Kisan Mandhan Yojana has been launched on 12th of September 2019 at which of the following places? So Kisan Mandhan Yojana was launched in Ranchi, Jharkhand. Moving to question number 8th. Union Minister of State for Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has launched a multilingual mobile app for crop residue management named What is the name of the multilingual mobile app? This is also important because this has been released by the Agriculture and Farmers Welfare Ministry. Crop residue management. So, crop residues have caused a lot of pollution in the states of Haryana and Punjab especially. So, crop residue management, the app is going to help the farmers. It is called as CSC Farm Machinery App. Great. Straw burning events in 2018 have reduced by dash and dash as compared to that in 2017 and 16 respectively. So this was the data which was released by the government recently against straw burning, you see. So the answer here is 15% and 41%. So as compared to 2017, 15% it has reduced. If we compare 2000 year straw burning events to 2016, it's 41%. So although this is appreciable amount of reduction in the straw burning events, but it is not enough. Government has imposed a minimum export price for onions at how much USD per metric ton? See, onions were in news a lot because of the sky high prices they had touched. So the question is, a minimum export price for onions has been fixed at how much? I'll just wait for the answer. USD 850 per metric ton. How much amount of financial assistance is provided by the government per mega food park project? So mega food park. So this is important. Mega food parks are being established by the government to give a push to the food processing industry of India, which will directly help in catering to the doubling of the income of the farmers. So 2022 is almost here. Let's see if we will be able to double the income of our farmers. But nevertheless, the question is, how much amount of financial assistance is provided by the government per mega food park project? 50 crore. Correct. Very nice. Arpit, Akshat, Sunil, Deepanshu, Nikhil, Sangeeta. Sangeeta, no, it's not 10 crore. It's 50. World Bank has announced to provide an assistance of how much money to food parks in India in September 2019. It was announced. So again, food park schemes, you see. September month questions, these will be followed by October and then November. We'll also be doing questions from December, today itself. The answer is 3,000 crore. So World Bank has said that food parks in India would be provided an assistance of rupees 3,000 crore. And this announcement by World Bank was made at 15th Indo-US Economic Summit. So coming to Indo-US Economic Summit, this announcement, see these questions? World Bank has, first of all, it was asked how much amount of investment is done by the governments in the food parks. Then secondly, World Bank has announced an announcement of how much. Thirdly, where was it announced? It was announced at Indo-US Economic Summit. So the question is, where was the summit held? So this is the way you have to prepare, okay? You read a news, fine. But what are the dimensions you have to cover from that news? You read a scheme, that's fine. So many things are there. Long documents are produced by the government. But you have to pick up the most important things for the examination. So, coming back here, Indo-US Economic Summit has taken place in New Delhi, the national capital. It's very easy. Indo-US Economic Summit taken place in our capital, New Delhi. An agri platform, Dehat, has signed a memorandum of understanding with which of the following to work with lychee farmers in India. So, Dehat is an agri-tech platform and it has signed an MOU with a company for the lychee farmers in India. I'll tell you one thing. This company is going to produce some drink with lychee. And what do you... the drink is produced by your very famous company, Coca-Cola India. So, there are categories of people who like Pepsi and there are people who like Coca-Cola. Or Coke, we can say, which is producing the Coke. So, kind of that thing you can implement here. So, lychee farmers in India have signed a pact, are going to be helped by Coca-Cola India through the AgriTech platform. Very nice. I can see all of you answering this. And welcome to the students who have just joined in. I'm really glad that you guys are here. And you must tell all your friends about these sessions also. Most of the people should benefit from here. Moving to question 50. Which of the following state governments has recently passed a new scheme called Dues Recovery and Settlement Scheme 2019-20? Someone is saying, your voice is like you have cough of even, is it? I don't know why is it so. But I do not have any cough or fever, do not worry. And thank you that you guys are worried. I am perfectly fine. So, Dues Recovery and Settlement Scheme 2019-20 has been launched by Punjab. So, this scheme is related to the sugar mills. The people who are the owners of sugar mill, so that recovery can be done from that particular sugar mill. Dipanshu is saying, Mera Punjab, that's really nice. No, 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 it's not Maharashtra, it's Punjab. Please, Dues Recovery and Settlement Scheme. Current bill of the Government of India for the import of edible oils is how much per year? This is also important, 2018-19, this is import of edible oils. The bill is 60,000 crore per year. Shall I move to next question? Oilseed production has gone up from 25.1 million tons during 2003-04 to around how much during 2018-19? This is also important. So, oilseeds production has gone up. You can see that more than 10 years, almost 15 years data, comparison data has been taken. So, the answer is 32.26 million tons. So, this is what has increased. Fine. Next is pulses production in India has risen from 16.3 million tons to how many tons in 2017-18? Four option is it? So, pulses production from 16.3 million tons has increased to 25.42 million tons. It is an increase of 55% over these 3 years. So, it's very difficult to keep a tab over it. Difficult to remember, right? That what is the amount, what is the exact amount in million tons. I agree it is difficult, but it is important. Secondly, you have to keep in mind the percentage also, 55%. Because this is the recent data released by the government. Who has acquired a central registration for the brand owner under CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board, in line with the Plastic Waste Management Amendment Rule 2018 and also got the license? Central registration has been acquired by Mother Dairy, and also among the dairy cooperatives, Mother Dairy is the first to do this. So, in line with the plastic waste management rules, it has got the license under CPCB. So, Mother Dairy is the answer. This is also important. Very nice. Many of you are answering Sandeep, Pavitra, Shehzadi. First ones to answer. Which among the following variety has been developed by Indian Institute of Horticultural Research exclusively meant for the processing industry? So here, very important thing. Apart from this question, I'll tell you two important things to take away from this question. So Arka Lokesh, Arka Vishesh, Arka Apeksha. I'll see if you know it. The answer to this question is both 2 and 3. Fine. Just give me a second. I am not able to see the chat. Fine, it's fine. So yes, this is what I was telling. Someone is asking which variety it is, and see, even someone has given the answer fruit variety. So this is what I was telling you. Apart from knowing this, that these are the varieties which have been developed by Indian Institute of Horticultural Research, you have to know that Arka Vishesh and Arka Apeksha are the varieties of tomato. These are some hybrid tomato varieties which have been developed by IIHR. Secondly, you have to know where is IIHR located. Tell me quickly. Let me see if you know it, because obviously these are also important. IIHR is located in Bengaluru, Karnataka. Who has been elected as the chairman of International Egg Commission for the next 2 years, starting from the year 2019? Sumit, I've given the answer already. A horticulture institute is located in Bengaluru, Karnataka. It's not Hyderabad. Coming back to the question which is here in front of us. Chairman of IEC, International Egg Commission. So an Indian has been elected the chairman of IEC. The answer is Suresh Chitturi. And IEC is itself very important, an international body this is. The next question is, where is it located? So the headquarter of IEC is in, let me see if you know this. Perfectly imperfect, will you be able to answer this question also? I am glad that you answer almost all the questions. People are saying London, right? London, United Kingdom. Next question. Atul Chaturvedi has been re-elected as the president of Solvent Extractors Association of India for a term of how many years? So, you have to tell this. See, the Solvent Extractors Association of India is actually an NGO and it has been recognized by Ministry of Agriculture. Fine. It is also recognized by Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So, you have to, this appointment is important. Although for how many years is not that important, but it is important that who has been appointed the head. So it was the SEA was formed in which of the following years? SEA was formed in 1963. As I've told you, SEA is an NGO and it works for the Solvent Extractors Association. Basically, it is also considered as the main vegetable oil body of India, working for the welfare of the people who are involved in the same business. Agricultural company Syngenta has set up an innovation and learning center at which of the following places? Syngenta has set up its innovation and learning center in Andhra Pradesh. 15th session of South Asian Seasonal Climate Outlook Forum has taken place in the month of September at which of the following places? So all the cities of Kerala are here. So state in which this South Asian Seasonal Climate Outlook Forum has taken place is Kerala. And this place, city in Kerala is Thiruvananthapuram. Andhra Pradesh, how can you say Andhra Pradesh? Even Andhra Pradesh is not in the options given here. Correct, Thiruvananthapuram, the answer is option 3. So, yes, again question, it is a kind of static question, but it is important. So this forum, South Asian Seasonal Climate Outlook Forum, was established in which of the following year? The 15th edition, 15th meeting of the same, which has recently taken place in Kerala, Thiruvananthapuram. You have to tell in which year it was established. 2010. PM Kisan Yojana provides how much annual payout to farmers in three equal installments. Very important this is. PM Kisan Yojana provides how much annual payout to farmers. PM Kisan is a very important Yojana. I think West Bengal has opted out of this Yojana. It is not implementing it. So, in three equal installments, the amount given is 6,000. Correct. Very nice. As per the first advance estimates released by Agriculture Ministry recently, that is, it was released in September 2019, because the questions are pertaining to September only. So, as per the first advanced estimates released by Agri Ministry, India's food grain production during the rain-fed Kharif season is estimated at. So, you have to tell what is the food grain production according to the advanced estimates. 140.57 million tons. Correct. It is 140.57. Option 1. So, a new variety of ladyfinger Kashi Lalima has been developed by the scientist from which of the following? So, from where the scientists developed this Kashi Lalima? So, here again, see, this question is fine, but do not forget to take away the key points. For example, this Kashi Lalima is what? This also you should know. It's a new variety of ladyfinger recently developed. Secondly, who has developed it? Scientist from which place? The answer here is Indian Institute of Vegetable Research. So, as far as I know, IIHR is in Bangalore, that I have told you. Then, Indian Institute of Vegetable Research is in Uttar Pradesh. Fine. IARI is in New Delhi. And I don't know about Root Research Institute. These three, I am not able to recall about fourth one. But these three, these institutes' headquarters are also important. Last time, NABARD asked about two headquarters, like medicinal and aromatic plants. Central Institute of Medicinal and Aromatic Plants was asked in NABARD. CMAP, where is its headquarter? So, you have to know the headquarters of such important institutions, which are especially in news, because CMAP was in news. It had signed an MOU with some US firm. Uttar Pradesh, Varanasi. Theek hai. Uttar Pradesh, I said, and you are saying Varanasi. That's nice. Chale aage to next question. Pusa Chickpea 10216 is which type of variety? So, it's a chickpea variety. Pusa, see, a lot of things are being told in this question itself. Chickpea variety 10216 has been developed by Pusa. Fine. Now, what is it? What type of variety is it? Drought tolerant is it, water loving, shade loving, or all of these, or none of the above? So, Pusa Chickpea 10216 is a variety of chickpea which is drought tolerant. It has been developed by Pusa. Very nice, Sangeeta, very nice. From the month of October, farmers can avail solar water pumps from which scheme on the basis of Aadhaar card? So, yes, solar water pumps are here. You have to tell under which scheme on the basis of Aadhaar card farmer will be able to avail these water pumps. The answer is Kusum. Kusum also was asked in exam. Do you know the acronym for Kusum was asked in the exam of NABARD? So, these are the type of questions asked. Fine. We are trying to pick each and every question which is relevant for the exam here, because you people are devoting so much time here. Okay, so Kusum is here, Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uthan Maha Abhiyan Scheme for Farmers. You have to tell it has been launched by which ministry. You must have gone with either Ministry of Agri and Farmers Welfare or with MNRE or with both. The answer is MNRE. So, Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uthan Mahabhiyan was launched by Ministry of New and Renewable Energy because solar energy is focused. Urja Suraksha Abhiyan. To install solar panels under this Kusum scheme, farmers have to pay how much percentage of the total cost of the equipment? Very important this is also. Answer quickly. We have to discuss more than 100 questions today. Kisan has to pay 10% of the total cost of the equipment of the solar panel which is installed under Kusum scheme, which is run by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. Very nice. It's not 30, it's 10%. Okay, new protein rich wheat variety HD3226 is also referred as Pusa Harikiran, Pusa Kusum, Pusa Yashasvi, Pusa Harit, or none of the above. So, wheat variety HD3226 is protein rich. Secondly, HD3226 is a wheat variety. Fine. Thirdly, it is also called as Pusa Yashasvi. Fine, so September current affairs are done. Shall we start with October? Are you guys liking the session? Are you finding it beneficial? I am starting with October. Okay. Great. Next question is, recently in the month of October 2019, Government of India has relaxed mandatory Aadhaar seeding for which of the following schemes? This you can answer very easily, right? Because we read about Aadhaar seeding. The answer is PM Kisan. Just in the previous month, we have covered that through Aadhaar seeding, farmers can avail the Kusum. Sorry, this is PM Kisan. Dipanshu is saying already like the session. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You people are liking it and I really hope this is beneficial for you because you people are devoting your time also. Which of the following days has been celebrated for the first time in 2019? So, I'll tell you. World Cotton Day was celebrated for the very first time in the year 2019 on 7th October. So from now, 7th October will be celebrated as the World Cotton Day. How much area is currently covered under micro irrigation by the year 2018-19? This was also released by the government. Micro irrigation by the year 2018-19. How much area is covered? 11.58 lakh hectares. The government of Dash and World Bank have signed $165 million loan agreement to strengthen the smallholder farmers. So, government of which state has signed the loan agreement with World Bank? Randhir is asking outlay of scheme. Okay. This question I'm taking, but please, I will try to answer all your questions at the end of the session. Outlay of schemes released by the latest budget and also as announced by the scheme are important. So, here the answer is Odisha. So, Odisha government is going to strengthen smallholder farmers in association with World Bank. First ever IICTF, that is India International Cooperatives Trade Fair, will commence. Has actually taken place. You have to tell where has it taken place because the question pertains to October month. October has passed, right? So, International Cooperative Trade Fair has taken place in our national capital, New Delhi. So, India-US Economic Summit has recently taken place in New Delhi. First ever international IICTF has taken place in New Delhi. Two important things have taken place in New Delhi. International Day of Rural Women is observed on which of the following days? So, Rural Women International Day is observed on 15th October. प्राकृतिक खेती खुशहाल किसान स्कीम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड इन विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट्स. This is easy because if you are going through the ARD current affairs, you must know that one state is a lot in news due to its prakritik kheti. It is also called as zero budget natural farming. The term has been in news a lot. First organic state was Sikkim. That is fine. That question was also asked in NABARD, but earlier. But here, this scheme has been launched by this state. And I can see one student has answered Himachal Pradesh. Very nice. It's not Sikkim, it's Himachal Pradesh. So, Prakritik Kheti, Khushal Kisan Scheme. Zero budget, natural farming. Scheme has been launched by Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh is the state which is very quickly turning into the turning the agriculture into the ZBNF agriculture. Researchers have discovered new species of eel loach which is known as Pangaea bhujia. So, it has been discovered in which of the following states? So, this eel loach has been discovered in the state of Kerala. Saras Ajivika Mela is an initiative of which of the following ministries? I can see answer. Ministry of Rural Development. Ajivika Mela this is, and Ministry of Rural Development organizes this Ajivika Mela. Okay, what is the name of the satellite based advisory service which has been launched for seamless and effective dissemination of energy information and communication on disaster warnings, potential fishing zones and ocean states forecast to fishermen? So you have to tell the name of the satellite based advisory service. The answer is Gemini. Gemini has actually been developed by Ministry of Earth Sciences. This is important. Gemini we have covered earlier also. What is the MSP of wheat for the year 2020-2021? Important question. MSP of the wheat for this given year is ₹1925. Again, this is important because you have to know that what is MSP, minimum support price it is, and it is announced by CACP. This question was also asked in NABARD last year in 2018, I guess. 1925. I'm really glad it's not 1840, it's 1925. So, which of the following Rabi crops current MSP has shown maximum increase over the previous season MSP? So, for lentils, MSP has shown the maximum increase. How much provision someone is asked, what is the MSP? I'm not able to recall exactly the MSP for onion, okay? But please do find it out. How much provision has been made in the budget 2019-20 for eco-friendly management of crop residues? Okay, although the latest budget is out, this question also you people were asking in yesterday's session. Okay, if you guys did not go through the session, the yesterday's session, you could not join in due to some reason. We had discussed the strategies and the pointers. All our faculty members, Deepak sir was there, Anku sir was there, and even I was there. So you can go to the video and see the video right away, wherein we had discussed all the important things to be covered. Okay, coming back to the question. So although the latest budget is important, but this is also important. Eco-friendly management of crop residue is ₹1140. Which of the following model of integrated farming system is being suggested as most profitable for the areas having rainfall between 700 to 1100 mm? Calculated and recommendation. Okay, CACP is it? Yes, it is calculated by CACP, recommended by CACP. Obviously, announcement is done by the government. I agree. I completely agree. So, the answer here is horticulture livestock. So, for the areas between 700 to 1100 mm, the horticulture livestock is the suggested profitable thing. Maximum number of mandis are registered on Enam in which of the following states? This is also important. Enam is itself very important. National Agriculture Market. So, you have to tell that how many maximum number of mandis are registered in which state. Enam is very important. Currently, maximum number of mandis registered under Enam are in Uttar Pradesh, the state of Uttar Pradesh. Secondly, Enam, I'll tell you, National Agriculture Market was launched in the year 2016 by the government to basically phase out the APMCs and to connect all the kisan, all the farmers with a virtual mandi. After that, Gujarat, someone is saying, nice. We are done with October. Shall we start with November also? I'll not take a break here. I'll quickly go away with November. Let's see the momentum. In which of the following cities, 8th session of the governing body of International Treaty of Plant Genetic Resources for Food and Agriculture was held in November? So, 8th session of the governing body of ITPGRFA has taken place. The place is Rome. Rome is also the headquarter of FAO. In which of the following cities, 6th World Congress on Rural and Agri-Finance was held? So, the 6th World Congress has taken place in New Delhi. Indian Oil Corporation has received environment clearance from Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change to set up a new 2G ethanol plant in which of the following cities? What is the answer? This, if you are following these sessions regularly, you must be able to answer this question even if you haven't read it earlier. I have discussed this question in a GA session. I think GA lecture 1 or lecture 2. This is lecture 5th, right? So, we are planning to take sessions till 24th. So, 4 lectures have already been done. This is lecture 5th. If you have missed those sessions, go back. 2 lectures were dedicated to GA news. 2 were dedicated to ESI news. These 2, today's and tomorrow's, would be dedicated to ARD. Agriculture, Rural Development, Current Affairs. So, what is the answer? Panipat. Right. It is Panipat. Panipat is in Haryana. Actually, all these places apart from Patiala and Patiala and Mohali are in Punjab. Rest 3 are in Haryana. So, Panipat, this is going to be set up by Indian Oil Corporation. So, in which of the following states, first ever international buyer-seller meet on agriculture and horticulture produce was held? This is also important because first ever international buyer-seller meet has taken place. Let me see. I will wait for this answer. Interesting and important question. Meghalaya, is it? The answer is Arunachal Pradesh. So, first ever international buyer-seller meet on agriculture was held in Arunachal Pradesh. India has hosted 8th International Conference on Agri Statistics in which of the following places? I will go back to the previous question. I knew this doubt could have come. Someone is answering Assam. Assam also hosted a buyer-seller meet. But first ever international buyer-seller meet took place in Arunachal Pradesh in the month of November. Please note it down. That is the reason I have put this question here. Coming here, 8th International Conference on Agri Statistics has taken place in, again, our national capital, New Delhi. All these statistics are calculated in our capital, right? So, let's assume that this statistics is also related to New Delhi. Okay. Recently, which of the following stock exchanges has launched Agri Futures Index AgriDex in tie-up with NEC Indices Limited? AgriDex has been launched by NCDEX, National Commodity Derivative Exchange of India. So, in tie-up with NSE, this AgriDex has been launched. I would suggest you to not get involved in chit-chat, rather focus here, okay? Which of the following companies has developed an eco-friendly alternative to stubble burning? This is also important. Stubble burning, straw burning, these are important, right? So Happy Cedar is also there, a machine which is used to avoid this thing, stubble burning. So a company called as Canbiosis has come up with an eco-friendly alternative. It has said that it has actually developed a microbial solution called as Speed Compost for the same. It says that the stubble which is left over is not required to be burnt, but see, it can be put in Speed Compost, wherein microbial solution would be put, and it will be done. From Pune, right. Cotton Association of India has projected cotton output for 2019-20 is Canbiosis. Everyone knows this, that's really nice. So Cotton Association of India has projected cotton output is 354.5 lakh bales. As per the recent estimate by ISMA, that is Indian Sugar Mills Association, total sugar production in the country in the current sugar season would be around 3, I am getting the option as, it's 260 lakh tons. So total sugar production in the country in current sugar season would be 260 lakh tons. It's not 290, it's 260. In which of the following cities Aikar National Rice Research Institute has organized Rice Walk, Walk with Rice, Know Your Rice program? So this program was launched in the city of Cuttack. Secondly, I'll tell you that this program by a National Rice Research Institute was called as Rice Walk, Walk with Rice, Know Your Rice. This you have to know what is it, okay? In which of the following places 14th International Crop Science Conference and Exhibition was held in November? So 4th International Crop Science Conference and Exhibition has taken place in Gurgaon. It is actually now Gurugram in Haryana. Gurugram is also called as our solar city because it is also the headquarter of the ISA, International Solar Alliance. So first international alliance whose headquarter is in India, in Gurugram, Haryana. Cuttack, nice. In which of the following states 5th edition of the Pulses Conclave has taken place? Actually, see, in November it was announced this Pulse Conclave is going to take place in February, which has now taken place. So you have to tell where has this taken place. Maharashtra, right. 5th edition of Wasteland Atlas 2019 was released by, Wasteland Atlas is important, and the ministry which has released the same. Let me see if you guys know the answer. Okay, so it's very easy for them, for the students who are from Maharashtra only, to recall that the same has taken place in their own state. Coming back here, 5th edition of Wasteland Atlas has been released by Ministry of Rural Development. Correct, option 2 I can see. Ansh, it's not option 3. In which of the following cities International Conference on Soil and Water Resources Management for Climate Smart Agriculture and Global Food and Livelihood Security was held? So most of the conferences and summits have taken place in November, right? So this has taken place in New Delhi again. So statistics, agri statistics conference in New Delhi, then International Conference on Soil and Water Resources in New Delhi, then Indo-US Economic Summit in New Delhi. 65th question, we are here. Which of the following villages has acquired a badge of honor of first eco-village of Odisha? So this was in news that Muduludi Gadia is the first eco-village of Odisha, but I'll tell you that first eco-village of India was in Gujarat. This you can note down, okay, that first eco-village of India is in Gujarat. Ministry of Home Affairs has released the final report of the accident deaths and suicides in India. As per the report, which of the following states account for the highest number of farmer suicides in the country in 2016? Though, see, this report has been released recently, but the data used is of 2016. So this also doubt, this kind of doubt the students who have enrolled to our course, many datas, all important datas we have provided in the course. So they ask that, why is it so that in 2020 we are reading the same? Census you read, right? 2011 it was released. SCCC you read, it was released in 2011. So this data is released recently, but the data which has it has analyzed is of the year 2016. So the answer is Maharashtra. So the highest number of farmers users in the country have taken place in the Maharashtra. In which of the following places first Agrochemicals Congress, country status on various fronts of agrichemicals, was held? The place is New Delhi. In which of the following places 11th edition of BioFac India was held? BioFac India has taken place in Greater Noida. Which of the following states has recently announced rupees 700 crore relief package for rain hit farmers? I'll just take a break of 2 seconds. Which of the following states has announced rupees 700 crore relief package for rain hit farmers? The answer is Gujarat. Nice. The law to create farmers welfare board in the state has been passed by Kerala. So Kerala is the state which has passed a resolution to taking back CAA. This we had covered earlier in our previous sessions. So the law to create farmers welfare board in the state has also been passed by Odisha. Authorized capital of FCI has increased from rupees 3500 crore to dash. This is very important. Recently it was announced in November that authorized capital of FCI is going to be increased. You have to tell what is it. Rupees 35 crore to 10,000 crore. This amount you have to, yes, keep in mind. Do not think that you do not need to keep this exact amount, earlier and current one. Both you need to keep in mind. Fertilizer Association of India has held its annual seminar for the year 2019 in which of the following places? So FAI, Fertilizer Association of India, has taken its annual seminar in New Delhi. So most of the seminars were taken place in New Delhi only. Okay. On the occasion of National Milk Day, which of the following has launched the 12-point action plan to ensure safety and quality of milk and milk products? So you have to tell that on the occasion of National Milk Day, the 12-point action plan agenda was launched by whom? FCI, APDA, FSSAI, TriFed, or none of the above? FSSAI, correct. It is FSSAI, and Milk Day is observed in India on 26th of November. It is observed to commemorate the birth anniversary of Varghese Kurien. He is famously called as the national milkman or milkman of India. So Varghese Kurien, and I think the World Milk Day is observed on 1st of June. Very nice. 26th November, FSSAI. You all know this answer. In which of the following places 11th Agrovision has taken place recently in November 2019? So 11th Agrovision has taken place in Nagpur. Quickly answer the question, please. We are on 75th question. Around 115 questions we'll be discussing today. In which of the following cities the 5th edition of India Rubber Meet is going to take place in February? So this meet has taken place, Rubber Meet has taken place in Chennai. So Rubber, India Rubber Meet. How do you remember all these rubber, different meets, different conferences? I'll tell you my way. India Rubber Meet, Rubber, MRF tires are very famous. So I have learned that MRF stands for Madras Rubber Factory. So rubber are related to Madras, Chennai. So rubber meet in Chennai. So just a trick, if you are able to recall this thing in exam, or you are able to connect such things so that you can answer the same in exam. Recently, which of the following Agri University has established oxygen park with Bima Bamboo? So these universities also, you must know that PAU is in Ludhiana, GB Pant University is in Pantnagar, Indira Gandhi Krishi Vishwavidyalaya Raipur, Rajmata Vijay Raje Sindhya Krishi Vishwavidyalaya is in Gwalior, Madhya Pradesh, Tamil Nadu Agriculture University is in Coimbatore. Thank you for the, if you like the trick, thank you. The answer I'm getting here is Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, which is in Coimbatore. Very nice. In which of the following places the headquarters of National Institute of Advanced Studies located? So, advanced studies is again easy. Most, one of the most advanced cities is Bengaluru, as it is called as Silicon Valley of India. So, advanced studies has a center has to be in the one of the most advanced cities, that is Bengaluru in India. Which of the following will organize second edition of AgriTech South Expo and AgriVision Conference in January 2020? Okay, this has also taken place then. So, AgriTech South Expo was organized by CII, Confederation of Indian Industry. Chairman of NABARD, this you also have to know. Chairman of NABARD is Shri Harsh Kumar Bhanwala. So, chairman has announced that NABARD has a headroom to raise about dash from the market. This was announced in November. Okay, that's still the year we have for the current year. This much amount is still to be raised by the NABARD. The answer is 35,000 crore. Harsh Kumar Bhanwala is the chairman of NABARD. The tenure has been extended recently. India's first ever international conference on blue economy and aquatic resources has been organized. The conference was called Aquabe. You have to tell where has it taken place. So Aquabe is what? This you also have to know. Second, where has it taken place? So in Kochi, Kerala again. National Seminar on Social Audit of Rural Development has taken place in which of the following places? The answer is New Delhi. Okay, coming to December, shall we take a break of few seconds? Or shall we just start with the questions? We have covered September, October, November, most important ARD MCQs related to your current affairs. I've also tried to tell you how these questions are important, what can be asked from the information given in the question. So, tell me, shall we wait or just start? Okay, you have a break of few seconds. You can just grab water, grab a Snickers. Anyhow, just few more questions are left. Thank you, Manish. Manish is saying best discussion. Thank you so much. We are really humbled. Teja, you are already on break. Thank you, Dipanshu. I have taken water. So we are done with few seconds break. Let's start back. First question is here. To prepare which of the following plant saplings, a new low-cost technology has been developed by the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research and CSR CMAP Lucknow recently. This is what CMAP. This was asked in exam that where is the headquarter of CMAP. So see, such things you have to take out. So, the answer here is geranium. Scientists from CASR, CMAP have developed a low-cost technology to prepare geranium saplings, and this they have also made it available to the farmers. As per preliminary reports received from the states, total area sown under Rabi crop stands at dash hectares in the month of December. The answer here is 571.84 lakh. Geranium for aroma mission, someone has said. Sangeeta, that's really appreciable. Aroma mission, please guys, find it out if you do not know about it. This you can read through in the PDF which is available in the Telegram channel. Download the PDF later on. What amount of loan can a farmer avail for purchasing a buffalo with Pashu Kisan credit card? So Pashu Kisan Credit Card, more than 60,000 rupees loan can be availed to the farmer. 60,249 is the amount which is said. So Pashu Kisan Credit Card. To purchase a pig, farmer can get rupees 16,337 and to avail a buffalo 60,000, for a cow it's 40,000. Who has been appointed as the chairman of export committee of agri business and food processing in PhD Chamber of Commerce? This is typical, I know. The answer is Nand Kishore Agarwal. Which of the following insect is a species of family Acridiidae that have a swarming phase? This is also important. This was in news. Answer quickly. Just few more questions. Locust. So locust swarm attack was there in Gujarat. That is why this Acridiidae are in news. Swarming phase, these have locusts, and an attack was done in Gujarat. Grasshoppers family, these belong to, they have a swarming phase, and compensation by Gujarat has also been announced. So which of the following is the world's leading milk producing country that accounts for 19% of the global market share? World's leading milk producing country is India. Yes, this is again very important. You have to know. And the state which has the maximum milk per capita is Haryana. So yes, why is this in news? I'll tell you one thing. India is going to host the World Dairy Summit. So it was announced that in the year 2022, India will host for the first time the World Dairy Summit. Government has launched a new scheme, National Animal Disease Control Program. So which one of the following microorganisms causes brucellosis? We have read a lot about National Animal Disease Control Program launched in Mathura by Pradhan Mantri ji to eradicate this FMD and brucellosis from the livestock by the year 2030. Which microorganisms causes brucellosis? Answer is bacteria. FMD is caused by virus, brucellosis is caused by bacteria. This also you have to keep in mind. Although it's a bit typical, but it is important, okay? So, moving to next question. Which of the following venture capital fund has been set up by Indian Broiler Group Private Limited to boost agri-tech startups? Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi Scheme till 20th November 2019. So, PM Kisan is important, the acronym is important. Everything related to this scheme is important. So, you have to tell that how much benefit has been availed. The answer is 7.6 crore. Farmers have availed the benefit under it. Okay, under it, the beneficiaries from Uttar Pradesh were highest. Yes, maximum mandis in Enam are registered under Enam are also from Uttar Pradesh. So Uttar Pradesh is the state seems to taking the maximum benefit of the schemes by the government, it seems. So two things, Uttar Pradesh is at the highest. Center has decided to create a buffer stock of 1 lakh tons of onion in 2020. Which of the following agency will maintain this buffer stock on behalf of the government? So, buffer stock of 1 lakh tons of onion would be maintained this when recently the onion prices took reached sky high. Government announced earlier 56,000 tons of onion was stored, but that failed. So, this year government has announced that more buffer stock would be maintained. But which agency is going to do so? APIDA, is it? It is NAFED. You have to know the full forms also, okay? NCDC, FCI, APIDA, NAFED. You must know. It was asked in one of the exams, RBI, last year or the previous year, APIDA full form was asked. So, NAFED will maintain the buffer stock of onion on behalf of the government. Which of the following state governments has introduced rupees 10 thali scheme for farmers visiting the grain markets? This is very important. So, rupees 10 thali scheme has been launched by the government of Haryana. The farmers who are visiting the grain markets, they will be provided a thali, a very nutritious thali at the price of rupees 10. government subsidized canteens are going to provide these thalis. A very nutritious meal would be provided. And this is also be going to the launch to be launched to the sugar mills so that farmers get good food. Okay, at which of the following places Creamline Dairy Products Limited has announced to set up a dairy processing plant? So this is again related to your processing industry only. Creamline Dairy Products has said that they are going to set up a dairy processing plant in Sabbavaram, Andhra Pradesh. Shiv Bhojan in Maharashtra. Very nice. This question has been given by Perfectly Imperfect. See, yes, Shiv Bhojan has been announced by Maharashtra on the lines of this scheme only. Which of the following is the country's total area sown under Rabi crops till December 2019? Total area under Rabi crops is, this is a repeat question, is it? 571.84. Which of the following state government has announced its plan to set up over 18 clusters for the export of chemical residue free vegetable and fruits? I'll take up the questions later on. 18 clusters would be set up by the state of Maharashtra. Many, many students of ours are from Maharashtra. You must be able to recall it. Chemical residue free vegetable and fruits. What is India's export share of meat and chicken in global market? So in meat and chicken, India's share is 4.04%. Actually, this is a dismal share. And it is being planned that the export share of meat and chicken in the global market should be expanded. India has a very high scope there, but currently it is only 4.04%. You see here. A global market of meat chicken is very huge, but India's share is dismal. Which of the following countries, this we have done, World Dairy Summit, please tell, very easy. India. 2022 World Dairy Summit would be organized or hosted by India. India is going to organize this almost after 4 decades. According to a study from ratings agency Crisil, farmers are likely to generate what percent more in profit during the crop year 2019-20? The answer is 7-9%. So this is a study by Crisil. I would not say this is a very important question. How much hike in daily wages of the Kerala plantation workers has been done recently? So hike has been done by Kerala. A committee was specially set up for the Kerala plantation workers' wages, which recommended the improvement in the hike in the wages, which has been done, and it is 52 per day now. Which of the following universities has announced to open a school of smart agriculture recently? This is important. So smart agriculture would be set up in Dehradun, University of Petroleum and Energy Studies. Dehradun is in Uttarakhand. Which of the following crop plants has considered biosafe for direct utilization as food and feed processing by the Bureau of Plant Industry under Department of Agriculture? For Bureau of Plant Industry is under Department of Agriculture, under Ministry of Agriculture. So the answer is golden rice. It has been considered biosafe for the direct utilization. So IRRI, International Rice Research Institute, I think it's in Varanasi, and Philippine Rice Research Institute have announced this approval for the feed and food of this rice. At which of the following places 7th annual review workshop of National Innovation and Climate Resilient Agriculture has taken place? So this review workshop in NICRA has taken place in New Delhi. Hurry up quickly, just 10 more questions. 10 to 13 more questions to go. Which of the following digital platform has been launched by the global fintech solution provider BPC Banking Technologies recently? This is important for your GA also. So global fintech solution provider BPC has provided the digital platform Saffal Fasal. Fasal has to be Saffal. What amount of loan without any guarantee can a farmer avail on Kisan credit card for cultivation of various crops? KCC is a very important scheme of the government. So, loan which can be availed is rupees 1.6 lakh for various crops without any guarantee. This is the keyword. Without any guarantee, a farmer can avail the loan under Kisan Credit Card. Very important. Which of the following is an invention made by Kendriya Vidyalaya students that ensures equal distribution of drinking water through pipelines? Equal distribution of drinking water. The answer is smart water dispenser. Which of the following state is a leading producer of onion in India, which has a 30% of share? Manish, you are right. No collateral under KCC. 30% of the production share of onions is held by Maharashtra. This is again important. Leading producer of onion in India. This is also a very important question. Although it was in current, the onion production was in news. But this is a part of your static thing. ARD static, you guys keep on asking. Which of the following is the location of headquarter of Central Marine Fisheries Research Institute? This is also important. The answer is Kochi, Kerala. Sweet revolution. Tell me, very easy. I would want all of you to answer which one of the following is related to sweet revolution. Honey, the answer is honey is related to sweet revolution. India's first state to distribute Pashu Kisan credit cards. This we have seen, that Pashu Kisan credit cards, we have seen the scheme. It has been launched by the same state which has launched rupees 10 thali for the farmers. Which state was that? Tell me. Haryana, is it? Right. So, Pashu Kisan credit cards on lines of KCC have been launched by Haryana. Haryana is also the state which has launched the thali of rupees 10 for farmers who are visiting the grain market. Ginning and topping terms are related to which of the following crop plant? 110th question we are on. Cotton, ginning and topping are related to processing of cotton. These are associated with. This is very important. Please, FAO has declared the 2020 as an international year of which of the following? FAO, headquarter, you have to know. Secondly, 2020 has been declared international year of pulses. Do you think? It's International Year of Plant Health. Decade is for pulses, I think, but this year is of plant health. Okay, the answer is here. Odisha government has reduced the financial assistance given to farmers under Kalia scheme to rupees dash from rupees 10,000. So, 4,000. See, this Odisha government has done because they say that their scheme Kalia has been subsumed under PM Kisan only. So, this Kalia scheme was asked in last year's NABARD. To which state does it relate to? So that is why I say that state schemes recently launched are also important. So 4,000 has been reduced. Earlier it was 10,000 per annum. Okay, last questions. Which nodal agency has announced to bring in standards for animal feed recently? This also we have seen, FSSAI. Sugar mills were advised to export sugar as per their MIEQ allocation. What does MIEQ scheme stands for? Maximum indicative export quota, minimum indicative export quota, maximum industrial export quota, market marked Indian export quality, or minimum industrial exchange quota. This the ARD students must know. The answer is minimum indicative export quota, minimum support price, right? So related to MIEQ, minimum indicative export quota, and this term is specifically used for sugar, okay? Export of sugar. So sugar mills associated with MIEQ, it's very easy. Minimum support price, as you know, MSP, so minimum it has to be there, indicative export quota. Last question of the lecture. I think, let's see, it is the last or the we have another question too. Which of the following is the largest tree-borne fruit in the world? This is again static but was in news. Answer is jackfruit. So, jackfruit is the largest tree-borne fruit. So, this was the last question. In the world, jackfruit is the largest tree-borne fruit. That's okay if 2, 3, 4, 5 questions were wrong. That's completely okay, students. Exam is yet to take place and you must be prepared for exam. I think now you must be. So that's it. Before winding up the lecture, I really hope that you liked this lecture, you enjoyed the session, and I hope this is going to be very, very beneficial to you. And second thing, we are running a discount of 50% on the NABARD courses. Use the coupon code NABARD50 in caps. You do not have to use the space between NABARD and 50, NABARD50 together. And you can avail the discount of 50%. In case of any query, drop us a mail at hello@edutap.co.in. You can also visit our website wherein you can purchase the course. You can also give us a call at 8146207241. So winding up the session, you're welcome. Thank you so much that you guys are liking it. Any question? Anyhow, we are taking regular sessions for the strategy also. Your questions are answered there also. So please refer to the session of yesterday. It is available on our channel. Three faculty members have joined in there. Thank you, Siddhant. Vishal is asking all factual questions. Vishal, all these things are covered in our course already, be it static part, be it current part, everything is covered. So you must be able to answer these questions very easily if you are a subscriber to our course. You can revise, you must start revising if you have some doubt. ARD static, see, we are trying to cater to ARD part here, but we'll also come up with important reports, schemes, etc. related to ARD in these sessions. Someone is asking, is it possible that your classes will be there offline? We do not offer offline classes. We are an online institute. We are based in Chandigarh. So, we will not be able to cater the offline. So, winding up the session, wishing you all the very, very best for your exam. I will see you soon tomorrow.